I am Dawn Stevens with the Mom's Choice Awards. I have Mary Ficalora with us today, the author of Choosing Honor. Mary, we're really excited to have you back with us this year.
I'm very excited to be back.
Tell us about your book. You won the award last year.
Yes.
How has that helped you?
Huge, huge. The moms, hey moms, we're the ones that changed the world. And it's the moms that are going to make the difference. And my book's all about waking up, making choices, because we're the ones with the power, and there's a lot of mind games going on, there's wars, as it's an age of corruption. The book is about God, family, country, and an age of corruption. And as my editor said, when she first heard about it, she goes, oh, another housewife coming out with her, opinion, a mad woman. And no, this is about, pay attention, there are mind games. And if we have the power to really make a difference right now, because as it all comes crumbling down, financially especially, there's a reconfiguration taking place. And if we get involved and make that difference and pay attention to what the choices are that can be made, they will comply. Things are happening and it is changing. And the Mom's Choice were the ones that made them first look, made people go, well, what's that all about? Mom's Choice, isn't that for children? Moms, moms have a lot up there to work with, and we can make a difference.
So how do you feel your book inspires moms to do that, to make a difference?
What I've gotten from moms is the aha moments. Mm-hmm. You read it, and see, I'm what they used to call blue stocking, this researcher. I do a lot of research. There's intense research in this book, written very joyfully, but the facts are there. And when you see, oh, well, that's how it works. What? I always wondered about that. That's the kind of book it is. And it helps to get that insight. You may not agree with me, what I interpret it to mean, but at least it opens up your mind to, that's what was behind this war, the war on terror. Mm-hmm. That's what's behind these religions. Things like, where does purgatory come from? You don't realize it has a lot to do with money. Mm-hmm. And what else is in there that's aha? The power of families is a direct reflection to the powers of countries, to the powers of interpersonal relationships. And when you start understanding how you're relating to your husband and your wife, and how you relate to your children is a parallel to the rest of the world, and you start paying attention to that, which is the theme of the book. Pay attention to the way you, because we're what I call the fractal universe, how we are is a reflection of how the world is, right. And that's our power. That's what the book's
absolutely
about. Yeah.
And so in the past year, we've had a lot of changes. We've had Obama and tea parties happening, and it's still very relevant. Tell me how it all fits into what's happening today.
Well, when I started, I felt like no one knew this, where I didn't see it reflected anywhere. Mm-hmm. And I thought, and it was scary to me to put myself out there and say things that are in this book that I didn't think anyone else was saying. And then all of a sudden, there was the Ron Paul revolution. I was like, wow, things are going on. Mm-hmm. And the tea parties, and now the tea parties are gone a little too far in the wrong direction, I think, because it's all about bringing everybody together.
Right.
To me, it's Ron Paul, Dennis Kucinich, the two thinkers that are going to the Constitution, as far as country's concerned. And you don't want to be so fundamentally religious and conservative in your family that you're no longer inclusive of an entire community where everybody has to be harmonized, or else you know, if you have an outsider, you're going to have problems in your community.
Exactly.
So, the hate is where that bothers me, what's happened since. But I love the change. I love that there's a lot more activity on the internet of people making a difference, sharing information, getting outside the mainstream media and saying, what's going on? What's really happening? Why are they saying this when really it was that? So it's good.
Right.
Yeah.
Moms are really waking up and getting involved.
I think so.
The internet, but through your book as well.
I hope so. I do. I see a lot of good feedback coming back.
By all of that. Yeah. Well, we are so honored to have you as a winner.
Thank you.
And amongst us, what are some of your future plans going forward?
Education. I've been doing a lot of work in education and working with people at the university level and the education in the elementary level, and how elementary is so key. And a lot of the thinkers don't look at how the children are being taught. And some weird things are happening, so that's what's drawing me. what are we teaching our children?
Right.
And how does it relate to who we say we are?
So, and all that influence, I know there's the big battle going on in Texas right now with the curriculum. how that influences what we teach our kids.
Yes.
And it's a good thing that it's making the news, because I think it's waking moms up to who's writing curriculum and the objectives behind it of what's being taught to our kids.
Right, and where do we have to get involved to counter what's in textbooks? I don't think we think about that. I've never did before about, that's the textbook they were given to us, so we the book, and that's the truth.
And we assume because it's history, it's true.
It's the truth.
It's what's being
but
taught.
History's written but by the winners, and history's written by the people with the money to make the books to give to the children. And we really have to wake up to what's really important here and what's being taught. Yeah.
Well, thank you, Mary. We're definitely going to be watching you, because we have so much to learn from you.
Thank you.
And what our children are being taught. So thank you for your book and entering it.
Yes.
Happy to have it.
Thank you so much.
All right.
Thank you.